Hello and welcome back to our channel, AI Economist. We're delving into the third video of our Stable Diffusion Automatic 1111 Basics series. Today, we're going to guide you through the process of accurately downloading and installing checkpoints models. I've handpicked four models for you to get started with, as these trained models are going to be necessary in future videos discussing how to make money using Stable Diffusion and generative AI in general. If you don't want to miss out on future episodes, please make sure you hit the like button, subscribe to our channel, and don't forget to ring the bell for timely notifications. Also, we'll be doing a comparative analysis of two of my favorite realistic models. So, don't go anywhere, stay tuned. One of the top resources to safely download model checkpoints, LoRAs, embeddings, and much more is civiai.com. This website is backed by an incredibly supportive community and can significantly help you kickstart the creation of engaging videos and images, so don't hesitate to visit it regularly. Our first model for today is Western Animation Diffusion. This model was uploaded in June 2023 and is built on the framework of SD 1.5. This means it operates swiftly, even on GPUs with low VRAM. Its training was based on Western-style cartoon screen caps and comic books. Now, you might be wondering, where would we use such a model? To answer that quickly, it'll be utilized in numerous upcoming projects on this channel, including the creation of eye-catching YouTube thumbnails like these. To download the model, click on the Download drop-down button and select one from the two presented files. If you're running low on disk drive space, opt for the 2 GB model. Our next model, DreamShaper XL 1.0. This incredible model was released in July 2023, and it's based on SDXL 1.0. With DreamShaper XL, you can create stunning images that will take your digital art to new heights. From logos to t-shirt designs and even coloring books, this model will be a valuable tool for all your illustration needs. Stay tuned as we showcase its capabilities in our upcoming videos. Moving on, we have two fantastic realistic image models that we will be featuring in our upcoming tutorials. Let's begin with RealisticVision version 5.1. This incredible model is known for its ability to generate breathtaking portraits and cinematic pictures. Be sure to download this model, as we will dive into its usage and techniques in this video. Now let's talk about the second realistic model, epiCRealism. This particular model is my personal favorite, as it has consistently produced remarkable results. I can't wait to share its capabilities with you in the upcoming section of this video, where we will compare and contrast it with RealisticVision 5.1. Don't forget to download epiCRealism, as it promises to deliver extraordinary outcomes. Let's navigate to our download folder and proceed with copying all the models into our Automatic 1111. Inside our Stable Diffusion folder, locate the Models subfolder. Once you've found it, paste the copied models directly into this folder. In addition to the models, we also need to download the upscalers. We will acquire the 4X Ultra Sharp upscaler for RealisticVision and the 4X NMKD Superscale upscaler for epiCRealism. You can find the download links in the video description. Once the upscalers have been downloaded, copy them to the Automatic 1111 folder. Now navigate to the Models subfolder, and within that, locate the eEsergan folder, paste the downloaded upscaler files into this folder. Now to the fun part, comparing RealisticVision with epiCRealism. To start off, let's use the following positive prompt for epiCRealism. Raw photo face portrait of a beautiful woman with a cute face, wearing a black summer dress, happy, and flash photo. I will make sure to leave all prompts in the description below. Now that we have our prompt ready, firstly, make sure to select DPM++ 2M Keras as the sampling method. In the Hires Fix section, choose 4X NMKD Superscale from the Upscalers dropdown. Set the upscale denoising strength to a low value, such as 0.25 for optimal results. When it comes to the image size, it is recommended to use 512 pixels in width and 768 pixels in height. For now, let's keep the CFG scale at 7. Now go ahead and generate the image. Wow, the generated image looks absolutely fantastic. The lighting in the scene is simply amazing. The girl's skin is incredibly detailed and realistic. The hair rendering is particularly noteworthy. Even the hands are well crafted. Overall, the output from Epic Realism is truly impressive. Let's now apply the same prompt to Realistic Vision. This time we will select DPM++ SDE Karas as the sampling method. In the high resolution fix, choose 4x ultra sharp as the upscaling method. Set the denoising strength to 0.25. Set the width to 512 and height to 768. Maintain the CFG scale at 7. Now proceed to generate the image and let's see how Realistic Vision interprets and renders our prompt. Impressive results indeed. The lighting in the generated image is truly striking, evoking a professional studio-like quality that sets it apart from Epic Realism. While Epic Realism showcased a raw and natural feel, Realistic Vision takes on a slightly more polished appearance. The hair rendering is commendable, with intricate details adding to its realistic appeal. However, one area that could benefit from further improvement is the skin texture. Using Loris to enhance the skin by incorporating more details, such as pores, would definitely elevate the overall realism of the image. We also have the option to utilize various control types within ControlNet, like Open Pose. Additionally, coupling it with depth can help maintain the original background of the image. If you're curious about how to install and operate ControlNet, simply click on the video linked in the card above to go directly to that tutorial. Now let's review the transformative results achieved using these techniques. Both images produced are immensely impressive. The image created by Realistic Vision exudes a professional studio-like aura. Meanwhile, Epic Realism did an excellent job blending natural lighting and incorporating astonishing detail in the background elements, like the stairs. Furthermore, the rendering of the hands by Epic Realism really stood out this time. Now it's your turn. Which model do you think outshone the other in terms of realism? Please let us know in the comments section. If you found this video useful, don't forget to show your support by hitting the like button. Share the video with your friends and do remember to subscribe to our channel to get notified when we release our next tutorial. Until then, farewell.